In this video, we'll learn how to design a database for a chat application, such as WhatsApp. Whether you're watching this video for a university project, or want to see an example of a database design, or want to improve your skills, seeing a database being designed to meet some requirements is a good way to understand how the process can be done. We'll briefly cover what the chat application is and what it needs to do, create our database design from scratch, and enhance it with each requirement that we add. Let's get into it. So what is a chat application? It's an application, either on a mobile or a computer, that allows people to send short messages to other people. I mentioned WhatsApp before, and that's the kind of example we use in this video. Other examples are the Messages app on mobile phones, Facebook Messenger, or Signal. Let's say we're designing the database for a new application. What do we need to design? We would start with the requirements, which would define what we want to do or what we need to do. I'll use a few sentences to describe what we want this chat application to do. You can use the same thing or you can come up with your own requirements. Either way, we use them as a starting point for our database. So, what are our requirements for this chat application? We want users to be able to use the application to send messages to other people. Messages are sent to a phone number, which can be a number they enter or a contact from their contact list. The contact list can be used to add people and phone numbers that the user wants to send messages to. For each contact, the user should be able to specify their first and last name, a profile photo image, and a phone number. When a user sends a message, they can send a text message only. We could look into audio, video, GIFs, and other images later, but for now, we can just keep it simple. The application allows for multiple people to be in a group message, and all people will be able to send messages to the group and view messages within the group. Groups can have names. If a person is removed from a group, they cannot see any messages that were sent after they were removed. And if they are added to a group after it's created, they cannot see any messages before they were added to the group. I think that's enough for now. We can design our database based on these requirements. Let's get started. We can start with a table for messages. We know that messages need to be stored in our application, so let's start with that. We'll create a table called Message. This will store the messages that we need to send to other people. This table will have a field called Message ID, which is the primary key. You can call it something else if you prefer, but as long as it's a primary key, it's okay. Next, we'll store the number that the message is sent from. This will be your phone number if you send the message, or another person if they send a message. We also have a toNumber field, which is the number that a message is sent to. The next field is the actual message that is sent, which is called message_text. Finally, we have the date and time the message was sent, which is the sent date time field. This is our simple message table. It allows us to store information about the messages, and the chat application can handle the functionality of sending the messages and choosing the recipient. What's next? In the requirements, we want the ability to send the messages to a contact. So instead of specifying a phone number, you can choose a contact in your address book. Let's add the ability to store that in our database. We've got a table here called Contact. This has a primary key called Contact ID. In our requirements, we wanted to store the first name, last name, a profile photo, and their phone number. These fields are optional, and the application will allow the user to provide this information. Now, how do we relate a message to a contact? The requirements say that a message can be sent to a number or a contact from their list. So, a message does not need to relate to a contact. How do we relate these two tables together? There are a couple of ways we can do this. If we add a contact ID to the message table as a foreign key, we can store messages that are sent to contacts. This would mean the toNumber can still be set, which could be different from the phone number for a contact. This is okay though, as it could be a valid situation. A contact is an up-to-date record of a person, while the message is a point-in-time record of something that happened. A contact could change their phone number, but the phone number for the original message would remain unchanged. Another way would be to not have the toNumber in the message table and look it up from the contact table. However, this would not allow for the database to store the number a message was sent to at the time. This may be a valid scenario. We don't know if that is important, and if this was a real system, we would want to check that. For this video, we'll assume we want to store the number, so we'll leave it in the message table. So we have a contact linked to a message table. What's next? The next feature to add is group messages. The requirements for this were that multiple people can be in a group message, all people can send and receive and view messages in the group, groups can have a name, and some rules around members only seeing messages while they are in the group. So how do we add this to our database? We can start with a table for the group. We'll call the table Message Group for now, as the word group is a reserved word in SQL. The table will have a primary key called Group ID, and we can add a name for the group. Now we have our Message Group table, let's see what we can add next. We have groups. We need to store the members of each group. How can we do that? A group can have multiple people or contacts inside it. Also, a contact can be in multiple groups. For example, you may have one group with just your siblings, so your brothers and sisters, and you may have another group for your entire family, which would include brothers, sisters, parents, children, and so on. So this is a many-to-many relationship. I created a video on how to model these in a database, which you can view in the description below. And it's done by creating a joining table between the two tables we want to relate. We would have a new table that contains a record for message group and a contact. We've called this group member. We can add in a foreign key for the contact ID column in the contact table and the group ID column in the message group table. We also need to add columns to show when the person joined the group and when the person left the group, so the application knows which messages the contact can see from this group. We've got the joined date time and left date time for that. So that's how a contact can be related to a group. Once we have the message group created, we need to be able to send messages to the group. To do this, we can relate a message to the message group. Add a foreign key to the message table to join the message group table, which can be called group ID. We can see that our tables are now related, but they are related in a circular way. Message to contact to group member to message group to message. Sometimes this can be valid, but most of the time it can indicate an issue in our database. What could the issue be? We can look at the message table. A message is related to a group. It also has a contact. What if a message is sent to a group and not a single person? One way we can address this is by thinking about the concept of a message group. This table allows the concept of sending a message to a group of contacts. However, if we design this to be more of a conversation, where a message can be sent to one person or multiple people, then we could make it work. To do this, we can rename our table from message group to conversation. We would also rename the columns in this table and in the related tables to conversation instead of group. We still have the circular relationships between our tables. Because the message is related to a conversation, we don't need to relate it to a contact. So we can remove the link between contact and message, which means removing the contact ID from the message table. We should also remove the two number field because we don't send a message to a single number. We can store all numbers that we send messages to as contacts, and the rest of the details in the contact table can be optional. The application can make this easy to do for the user. The user can still enter a single phone number for the message if they want, but in the background, a contact will be made. This also brings us to our final design for our requirements. We've got the ability to message one or more people, we can store contacts, and the application can show messages to people who are in a conversation at a point in time. What issues might we have with this? It doesn't store the phone number a message was sent to, because it may change. But the message is stored against the contact, so it may not be an issue. We could change the from number to refer to a contact instead of a phone number. This could mean each user is a contact in the application, but it's not something we did for our design. We could enhance the message text field to allow for other media types. We could do this by changing the data type to allow for files or references to files. There are a few ways we could do that. So those are some examples of how we could enhance this database. But the design we came up with will meet all our requirements for a chat application. And that brings us to the end of this video on designing a database for a chat application. If you learned something new from this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel. If you want to learn more about database design and development, visit databasestar.com. That's where I share my best database-related content. Which tip from this video was the most helpful? Was it the fact that we can make changes to things we've already designed as we go, or how we handle the many-to-many relationship or something else? Thanks for watching.